Okay, my question to Manute is, how come you feel they're not putting you in the offense, you know, a little bit more?
All right, how come the Bullets don't have you more actively involved in the offense right now?
Oh, I think, you know, I'm not worried about that right now. I think, you know, if I can play a good offense without no defense, I might not be good too in the league. So I think, you know, maybe my offense might come along. And right now I'm working to, you know, play hard on defense, and I can help my team roommate to win.
Basketball, I mean, you're still learning the game. It's relatively new.
No, I'm still learning the game, but, you know, like what I'm saying down there, I don't think I can learn the game, but I'm learning it, you know, watching TV, watching my, you know, somebody playing good offense. And I'm trying to learn, you know, to learn from coaches and myself. So I think, you know, maybe not this year, but next year I might, you know, be a good offensive player. I'm not saying that I want to score 30 points, 40 points, but I can score 10 points, 10 rebounds, maybe 10 block shots a game. I think it's enough.
That would be all right. All right, let's take some more phone calls. 202-822-6830 is our number to call on Home Team Sports Beat. Thank you for waiting. You're on the air with Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol.
Hello.
Hello, go ahead, please.
My name is Pat. I live in Forestville, and I'd like to put a question to Jeff.
All right, for Jeff Ruland.
Okay, Jeff, do you think it's beneficial for young men to go to summer training camps, and would you ever consider running one again?
Question is, for those who may not be able to hear it, does Jeff feel that sending youngsters to basketball summer camps is beneficial, and would he consider running one again?
I do run one, but it's in New York. It's at Iona College where I played. I recommend it, especially if you're in an area where there isn't a lot of competition when you're growing up. I myself, when I grew up in Long Island, after a certain age, there wasn't enough competition to help me improve. So I went to a basketball camp called Five Star Basketball Camp, which is run by Mr. Howard Garfinkel, and it's one of the elite basketball camps in the country, and it helped me improve a great deal. So yes to both questions.
How old were you when you first started playing basketball?
Well, seriously, it wasn't until after going into the ninth grade. I was played all sports. My first love was baseball. I was a good pitcher, but after going into ninth grade, I finally decided that it was going to be one sport, and it was going to be basketball.
How about you, Manute? When did you first start playing? Oh, later.
I started playing basketball in 1980.
1980, 6 years ago.
Yeah.
That's the first time you ever picked up a basketball.
Yeah, that was my first time seeing basketball, too. I never seen basketball before, so I guess, you know.
What were the circumstances that the first time you came in contact with the sport?
I know a lot about soccer and boxing and everything, but I didn't know that about basketball. My cousin, he played basketball in the national team for a few years, and he got a scholarship in Egypt. And after that, you know, he went back home to 1979, like December. And he told me, if I play ball, I can be a good ball player because, you know, my height. So I told him I don't want to play ball. And, you know, he's been talking to me for about 2 months. In 1980, I decided, you know, to play ball. And he taught me how to dribble and go lab. And I tried to dunk. I broke my teeth the first time.
Broke your teeth?
Yeah.
On the rim?
Yeah, on the rim. I dunked the ball, but I came down, I broke my teeth, so I tell him, you know, broke my teeth right now. I'm going to play ball and see what's going to happen later on. Is that what happened?
I've never heard anyone breaking their teeth on the rim, but if anyone can do it, it's you. All right, let's take some more calls for Manute Bol and Jeff Ruland. Thank you for waiting.
Yes, this is Jim Buckley calling from Hillcrest Heights, Maryland.
Hi, Jim,
my
question
is to Jeff Ruland. I do know that he left Iona to go play basketball in Italy, and I'm interested in asking him to tell me a little bit about the Italian league and what advantages does he feel he has by going to play in a league and coming into the NBA over some of the other stars that went right out of college into the NBA.
Well, first of all, I played in Spain, and the situation was that the Bullets still had Wes Unseld and Elvin Hayes, and I felt like that I wasn't going to get that much playing time, so I thought it was more beneficial for me to go over to overseas where I could play and develop my game. And when I got over there, it was a tough time. You know, it made me grow up a lot. And also, you know, I said to myself when I came back and started in the NBA that I was going to play hard and I was going to make sure that I wasn't going to go back overseas.
Do you think that maybe in the long run that experience benefited you? I'm acquainting it with guys who play in the CBA, who've been in the NBA before, and you see them come back and they say, I never want to ride a bus again. I don't want the $20 meal money or whatever they get. It made me appreciate the life I've got. You think that was the case with you playing in Spain?
To some degree, it was, you know, I had some tough times over there, and like I said, it helped me grow up, but I definitely said when I was going to, in the NBA, I was going to make the best shot I had. I was going to make sure that I wasn't going to go back over there.
All right, let's take some more phone calls for Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol. Our phone number again, 202-822-6830. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Hello.
Hi.
My question is to Manute Bol.
All right.
And I want to ask him, how is he doing in his weight gain program, and where does he see himself in the next 2 to 3 years in the NBA?
Very good question. For those who may not know, the Bullets have you on a weight training program with Frank Costello at the University of Maryland. How much weight have you put on?
I think I put about 20 pounds, and I came here, and right now, you know, I think I was working hard with him, and I think at that time, too, you know, I felt stronger more than before when I was in college. And right now, we've been traveling every day, so, I mean, I drive it down about a month, and I've been up lifting weights, but I'm going to come back in summer after the season and lifting weights again.
How much do you weigh right now? Do you have any idea?
No, I've been not weighing myself about 2 months from now.
Just a guess.
Yeah, maybe 207, 205, maybe.
205, 207.
Yeah.
Do you have a goal? I mean, would you like to weigh 230, 240, 250?
Yeah, I like to weigh like 220, 225. That's what I want to weigh, because I don't want to weigh too much in my height. If I weigh like 250, maybe I might not want. So, I mean, I like to weigh like 220, 225.
Are you, when the team is home, how often do you get to lift weights?
Like we don't have practice tomorrow, I might lift an hour and a half, you know. And,
but I mean, can you regularly lift 3 or 4 times a week, or is that difficult?
No, if we don't have a game, I can lift 3 times a week. I like to lift 3 times a week, but I don't have to lift weights every day, because, you know, you gotta take a rest day after day. So I think after season, I might lift like what I did before, 3 times a week.
All right. We're talking with Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol of the Washington Bullets, and we'll be back to take some more phone calls in just a moment. Stay with us. Welcome back to Home Team Sports Beat. I'm Mel Proctor, and we're pleased to have as our guest tonight two members of the Washington Bullets, Jeff Ruland, who'll be returning to action soon, and Manute Bol, who's already in action leading the NBA in block shots. And today the Bullets blocked 14 shots as a team. Manute had 6, Charles Jones had 6, and somebody else blocked 2 more. But they have really been knocking down the shots, and it's been exciting. Let's take some more phone calls. 202-822-6830 is our phone number here on Home Team Sports Beat. Thank you for waiting. You're on the air. Hello.
Hello. A couple of questions for Jeff Ruland.
All right.
Jeff, I'm from Long Island originally. Who'd you play your high school ball for?
Played for Sachem High in Ronkonkoma.
Oh, that's way out there. What year did you graduate?
77.
Okay, I gotcha. My question to you is this: after you completely heal, you're back on the courts for a couple of games. How long do you think you'll get back? It'll take before you get back to top form, like you were a couple of years ago. 2 years ago.
Depending on what game I come back, if we have a few days of practice, I think that will help me along, you know, tremendously. But it shouldn't take more than a week.
More than a week. All right. Are you looking forward to playing with Manute, as Gene has indicated that he may use you two together?
Well, Mel, prior to my injury, we played about 7 or 8 games where me and Manute were playing at least half a game together. And I thought that's when we started playing our best basketball of the year. And, you know, my ideal position is power forward, I believe. So I'm looking forward to it.
I mean, are you excited about this team now with Manute playing the way he is, with the defense overall playing so well, with Leon Wood just going wild of late?
Well, I was telling Manute driving down here, I was saying how I was going to wear my ring this summer.
The championship ring.
I think we're going to do it.
You can see the pieces slowly coming together, can't you?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, let's take some more phone calls for Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol. Thank you for waiting.
Yes, my name's Gordon Davis, and I like to ask Jeff Ruland, that what was the best defensive player you played against, and why?
Best defensive player you've ever faced?
Besides Manute? that's a hard question.
As I see it, it appears to me that you have more difficulty with the real big centers, the 7-footers and the guys 7'1", 7'2".
No, I really don't have any trouble with anybody. You know, to tell you the truth, the toughest player
Kareem
for me,
said that.
I've had no trouble with Kareem, to tell you the truth. I've always done well against him. Probably Caldwell Jones. Done the best job on me.
CJ's older brother.
Yes.
Why? What is it that he does?
He's just a smart player. He knows how to play me. He takes a step off. 7 footer, quick, yet strong. Most difficult for me.
Let's ask Manute the same question, only in reverse. Which player offensively has given you more problems than any other?
I think what's happening right now in the NBA, you know, the players getting better every night, and I think, you know, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, it was tough.
That skyhook?
Yeah. Because I tried, you know, to block his skyhook. I couldn't do it. So I just, you know, I say, let me try his jump shot and I can block it. So, I mean, I think it was tough, you know, to play Kareem because you want to play him outside. You want him to take a shot, not a hook shot. He drove to the basket. So, I mean, it was tough to play him. And I think, you know, he played a really good game, the first game without playing him. And I think, you know, Kareem is really playing hard, you know.
Did so you talk to Kareem at all when you played against him?
No, I didn't talk to him at all, but I like to talk to him. But, you know, I couldn't get a chance to talk to him at that time.
Okay, let's take some more phone calls for Jeff and Manute. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes, first of all, I'd just like to congratulate Manute Bol on excellent basketball here of lately, and tell Jeff Ruland that we're Bullet fans everywhere anxiously awaiting his return.
Thank you.
My question is to Mel Proctor on, maybe you can help me with this,
all right.
The scheduling of home Bullet basketball games. Last Monday, the Clippers at home was not on TV. Today's game against Chicago was not on. And I understand that Thursday night's game against Phoenix is not going to be on. And my question is, I wonder why Home Team Sports is not televising more of the home Bullet basketball games when no other TV stations are televising these games.
All right, that's a fair question, a good question. And the executives here at Home Team Sports, our general manager Bill Labor and our executive producer Jody Shapiro, really concern themselves more with the scheduling than I do. I have nothing to say about it, but we're trying to present a product to this area, Baltimore, Washington, Virginia, Delaware, North Carolina. We're trying to present something that appeals to all of the people. So we're trying to give you not only the Bullets, but the Caps, college basketball, and Lord knows we have some outstanding college basketball in this area. So we're trying to be as many things as we can to you, and that's and give you a full range of sporting events to choose from. But certainly there is the opportunity that if the Bullets get hot and start winning more games, we get down toward playoff time, we'll probably add some games. That would not surprise me at all. But thank you for your call. All right, let's take some more phone calls for Manute and Jeff. Thank you for waiting.
Yeah, hello. I'd like to ask Manute a question.
Go ahead,
could
please.
You give us some details about the time you killed the lion?
I knew that would come up. For those who may not know, and both of you, Manute, growing up in the Sudan, apparently killed a lion. The story has been so exaggerated by now that I'm not sure anyone really knows the truth. So what is the truth about the lion incident?
I don't understand why, you know, people have been asking me the same question every day.
You have to understand that people in the United States don't run around killing lions, so it is a little unusual.
Maybe I should take some people down there and they can see them alive. That was happening, you know, when I was young, 15 years, 16 years old. And what's happening is, you know, I was in the farmer area. So I tried, you know, to protect my father's cows, you know, walk around with them all day, bring them back home in the evening. It was happening here, the lie killed my cow. So I was mad, but I don't know if that was that lie would I kill or not, you know. So I was mad. I say, if I find them somewhere, you know, I might fight them. So, you know, it was happening here. Just happening the other time, I was walking with my cows, and I find it sleeping under the trees. So, I say to myself, let me kill it like what they killed my cow. So that happened about 7 years ago, you know.
Was it a big lion?
Oh, yeah, it's a really big one, you know. But it was sleeping. Even if it was not sleeping, too, I would not fight it. I would not fight it because, you know, it's tough to do those things.
Did you tap him on the shoulder before you killed him?
Yeah, you know, I was sleeping and I just shoot it, you know.
With a
spear, I don't know.
Spear?
Yeah, a spear. So, I mean, in that time, when it got up, you know, it broke the trees. And I just, you know, run under the trees and I hide myself because I don't want to see me.
I don't blame
you. Know, that was happening long ago. But I don't think a lot of people can believe it. But I'm still saying it, the same thing.
Okay. No, I think they could certainly believe it when they understand what it was like where you live. It's a little difficult to picture someone living in Chicago killing a lion.
In what's happening here, it's like in daytime, you don't see them lion and everything, but you can see other animals, you know, like giraffe and everything. They can come behind in the yard, you know, and everything. You can see them in daytime. But at nighttime, you can see a lot of animals too, because, you know, there's a lot of trees and everything down there. Nobody kill them a lot. People don't kill them that much.
I mean, on the average day in your backyard, you can walk out and see. What could you see, for example?
Well, you can see giraffe, you know.
Giraffe?
Yeah, you can see giraffe, and you can see other little animals. Not lion. You can see lion.
But
daytime.
Occasionally you'd see a lion.
You can see them. Maybe you walk far away from house, like maybe a half a mile. You can see them. Sometimes, not every day. You know, they don't show up every day. They just show up at nighttime.
All right. You leave little bowls of food out for them in the backyard?
No, you don't have to give them
up. They'll
find their food. They'll find their favorite food somewhere.
All right, so you have the facts on the lion story now from Manute Bol. Let's take a look at Manute in action. He's having a fantastic rookie year, leading the NBA in block shots, and as he gradually develops, really becoming a force. There's a Manute dunk. Another stuff by Manute. He had one of those today against Chicago. Now, here's what he does best, blocking shots. Was there someone who helped you in particular learning to block shots?
No, what happened is, you know, my defense was, I play only defense a lot, you know, on the game, because if I take a, you know, bad shot sometimes, I don't feel good, you know. I say maybe the team lost, maybe they might say that, you know, I lost the team. So what I have to do, I have to help everybody in the team, because what you know, a big guy in the team, you got to have everybody. So I've been practicing.
In this sequence here, you just blocked the shot of a man who's 7'3", Randy Brewer.
What I did, I've been practicing a lot, you know, like when I was in college too, and then the Bridgeport coach, my coach in college, he put two guys, he put one on the other side and one on another line, and they just pass the ball. I said that, they, you know, if they want to shoot the ball, I try to block both of them shots, so they pass the ball, and you know, I just run between them. That's what I do, because I've practice a lot, you know, block shot a lot. But right now I want to practice how to block shot in right hand, because I never use my right hand.
All right, we've seen you block shots, and fans are well aware of also what happened in Chicago last week when you got into a little scrap with Juwan Oldham of the Chicago Bulls, and we're going to see that coming up shortly with some live sound. That was about a week ago, the Bullets and the Bulls in Chicago. This is one of the great moves Manute made against Utah. And now it's on to Chicago and what happened a week ago.
The defense, Cal Macy, a good three-pointer.
Great rebound by Ronfield. Great effort. The ball was behind him over his head, and he still got it.
There's a fight going on with Manute.
Oh, Manute. Look out. They're really getting into it. Ronfield tackles Juwan Oldham. Fight, they're still talking. Here they go again. Right in front of us. Right in front of us. They're really getting into it. Look out. They're wailing at each other.
You know, he's... Manute is just a real nice person that wants to become an NBA player. I don't know what happened, you know, how it all happened. But it was unfortunate because I know Manute is not the type of person that wants to be fighting.
The first one, he fight me in my face. That's why I fight him back. If you miss me, I couldn't touch him. But he hurt me. Yeah, I'm hurting. I feel hurting. The first I saw, but he hit me. I saw, like, and I turned around. And, you know, the guy still coming. So, I mean, I'm not going to take it.
And since that incident, he is known to his teammates as Rambo, Manute Bol. I know you're unhappy that the incident occurred, and it's unfortunate, and both of you got fined, and Juwan Oldham was suspended. But I personally feel that there was a positive side to what happened. I think that you earned a lot of respect in the NBA, not only of the opposition, but of your teammates, for sticking up for yourself. Then what happened?
You know, I think what's happened here is the first time we played them in Chicago, the first game we played them in Chicago. It was, you know, article in the newspaper, he said that I'm not as strong and he's going to take a ball to the hole and dunk on me. And I read that in the morning. A lot of people read that. And, you know, in the game, he tried to dunk on me all the time and I blocked, you know, all his shots. And, you know, and after the game, the photo asked me and I told them, you know, what do you think about Johanna? I said, he's a good player, but you don't have it talking about people. Like, what you say, in the newspaper that you're going to dunk on me all the time. And tonight what's happening is he done dunk on me because, you know, I know he's a good player, but I don't have it talking about other players. I want to play in game and that all try to win. In the second game, we went back down there. In jump ball, I tried to shake his hand. He said, you know, he put my hand away, so I just walk away, you know, walk away from him. And what's happening is they was winning by 13, 11 points. And we came back, we playing great defense, great offense. And they shot the ball like once, or maybe 2 minutes left, or 1 minute left in the game, one in 30 seconds. They shot the ball, and I tried to box him out, you know, because I don't want him to get offense rebound. And, you know, I think I got a head in the back, and I just turned around. I asked him, what's your problem? He said a bad word. I can't say it in TV.
No, don't say it.
Gonna use it. Hey, they don't use that where I come from, you know, all the time.
You're learning some new words in this league, aren't you?
So, you know, and I say it back to him. I tried to walk away from him because I want to, you know, we got a ball, so I just went, you know, to the offense. And he walked to me, so he just pushed me. When he pushed me, I'd say, why you guys have to hurt me when I was touching him? So I fight him back. And I thought it was over in that time. And they threw me out of the game, and he was out of the game, too. I tried to walk to the locker room. Like what Coach said, you got to go to the locker room to protect me again. So in that time, I was ready to fight, but, you know.
All right, well, fortunately, no one was hurt, and... Yeah. They both got into your pocketbook a little bit, but...
Yeah, but I think, you know, I'm mad. I still have a question for NBA because, you know, I can't let the guy kill me without touching back, and they'll find me right now. So, I mean, I still have a question for NBA office.
All right, we'll give you the number of the NBA office, and you can call them in a couple minutes. We'll be back to talk more with Manute Bol and Jeff Ruland when Home Team Sports Beat continues. The Washington Bullets this afternoon at the Cap Center defeated the Chicago Bulls 112-98 as Jeff Malone matched his career high with 40 points, and the Bullets as a team blocked 14 shots. Another very impressive win for this Bullet team, which is rapidly shaping up. And we're happy tonight to have two members of the Bullets with it. Two key members, Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol. And we've got phone calls on top of phone calls. Let's go back and take some more calls. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes, I like to, my name is Sean Dennis, and I'm calling from Washington, D.C., and my question is to Manute.
All right.
How long do you think you'll be playing in the NBA, and do you feel good playing in the NBA?
We're having difficulty hearing your question. Could you ask it again, please?
I'm asking, do you feel good playing in the NBA, and how long do you think you'll be playing in the NBA?
All right, the question is, do you feel good, Manute, playing in the NBA, and how long do you think you'll play professional basketball?
I think I feel good, but I don't know how long I'm going to play in the NBA. Maybe I might not look good. Maybe next year or a few more years, I might not play in the NBA. If I still play hard, I can still, you know, play in the NBA for a few more years. But I don't know. I can't tell yet because you don't know what's going to happen later on.
Well, are you happy now? Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, I think I'm enjoying myself, you know, with my team roommate, you know. And I think I have a good year right now, too, you know. That's the way what I feel. So I think... I have a great year, and I feel good.
And as you look at your bank account about 5 years from now, I think you'll still enjoy playing. Okay, let's take some more phone calls. Do you have a question for Jeff Ruland or Manute Bol, give us a call. Thank you for waiting. Hello.
My name is Stanley Jones. I'm calling from Landover, Maryland.
All right.
With the amount of playing time the team has had without Ruland, with him coming back now, do you think that you all will really be contenders in the league? And I think Manute did a good job the other night. Like you said, he gained a lot of respect, and he needs that so they won't beat on him as much. Thank you.
All right, thank you for your call. Jeff, what about it? How good is this Bullet team going to be, or how good can they become with you returning to good health, with Manute developing as he has, with the addition of a Leon Wood?
I don't think we can be as good as anybody in the league, and that means Boston. You know, we're very deep now with the addition of Leon, and Manute's playing great, Malone's playing great, Gus, you can just go down the line. We're a very good basketball team.
The Bullets did lose Tom McMillan today. He injured his ankle and is going to be out for some time. They're going to examine that tomorrow and try to determine exactly what the nature of the injury is and how long he'll be out. So he's a key backup performer. I'm sure the team will miss him.
Definitely.
Okay, let's take some more calls for Manute and Jeff Ruland. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes. My name is Albert Samuels, and I'm calling from Waldorf. And I'd like to ask Manute. When he came to the Bullets, I heard that he could press bench press 60 pounds, and then I heard he could bench press 120. I'd like to know how much he's.
All right. When you first came to the Bullets and they put you on that weight program, how much weight could you bench press?
I think I thought with, I'm not remember, but I think I thought with like 20 or 30. And right now, I think, you know, after that, I think I've been lifting more than before, because but I don't know how much, you know, did I thought. The person was trading me. He knows, Frank knows that, but I don't know how much I, you know.
Frank Costello doesn't tell you how much weight you're lifting?
No, I don't follow those things. What I want to do, I want to go down there, you know, and work hard with him. That's all I want to do, but I don't
have. Do you feel yourself getting stronger?
Yeah, I feel more stronger than before, and I think I'm going to still work on it again.
I mean, can you feel the benefits of it when
I can
in a
feel
game?
It, I can feel it right now, in my, you know, like when I was playing USBL in summer. I was doing good, but not as good like what I do right now, because I've been, you know, playing against big guys. The way what I feel right now, I feel, you know, stronger more than.
And I think anyone before. Who's seen you play can see the benefits. And I saw you in training camp, and you were getting pushed around to some degree, and now you're holding your own against some of the bigger, stronger players in the league.
Yeah, I might hold myself maybe next year, not this year, but right now I'm trying to hold myself against other big guys. And I think, you know, Frank Costello did a good job, you know. He really helped me a lot, you know.
Okay, let's take some more calls for Manute and Jeff here on Home Team Sports Beat.
Hi, my name is Glenn Vickers. I'm from Bowie, Maryland. I have a question for Jeff Ruland.
Go ahead.
I've been following your career, Jeff, for about 6-7 years now. I've noticed you always wear low-top sneakers. Is there any reason for that? Don't you think high-top sneakers would be better for you?
I used to wear high-tops, but ever since after my rookie year, I switched to low-tops. I feel much more comfortable. I tape both my ankles, so I feel I don't have to wear high-tops. And get off the phone.
Is that a friend of yours?
Yes, it is.
That's what I told you before, too. Hmm? You got to wear high-tops.
You wear high-tops or low-tops?
Yeah, I tell him low-top, high-top.
You tell Jeff he should wear high-tops? Does he listen to you? Apparently not.
Maybe someday. He says feel better with them. So,
all right. Let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. Thank you for waiting. You're on the air.
Yeah, hi. I'd like to ask Jeff, what are the duties of assistant coach Don Moran? I see him introduced before the games, and I never hear much about him.
That's a good question. I really don't know. I know that Gene and Don went to school together in Maryland, and Don is usually around during training camp. He's a very successful businessman, and I think he just comes now and then to, you know, have some input in, but he's more or less really a friend of Gene's, I assume.
Well, you know, I'll further that. Donna is a wonderful guy, and he and Gene go all the way back to the University of Maryland when they played together, and when Gene coached in San Diego, Don was kind of in the same capacity, a part-time coach, and I think he's a sounding board for Gene. He's a trusted friend. Gene can confide in him and talk over things with him without having to worry about anything. Just two good friends who share their thoughts. He's also a very knowledgeable basketball man and has done some coaching himself, so I think Gene feels he's a great benefit to the team. And he will pick up a check occasionally, which is why
yes,
I like to have him around. Let's take some more calls. You're on Home Team Sports Beat. Hello. Go ahead, please.
My name is Jay Green from Pennsylvania.
All right,
and
Jay.
I'd like to know whether Manute Bol and Roman can really hang with the Lakers or the Sixers with that fast-paced game.
I guess the question is, Manute, when the Bullets, when Jeff returns and all the pieces are in place, can the Bullets stay with the 76ers and the Lakers and teams that like to run?
Oh, I think, you know, I think with Jeff coming back, we can play anybody. Like right now, without Jeff, I can't say that we can play against Lakers, but we can try it. But, you know, with Jeff going to come back, I think we can play any team.
And I think you'll see the team running more with the addition of Leon Wood. He's obviously, Jeff, more effective in a running game.
Definitely. He's, you know, get the ball up court, and he's got a great touch.
He was a factor today. He only scored 1 point. I think he was 0 for 8 or 0 for 9 from the floor, but he was a definite factor because Chicago went into a trapping defense and cut the Bullets' lead to 5 points in the second half. Gene Shue brought him off the bench, and he's so quick and such a good ball handler. they couldn't trap him, and they had to take the trap off, and bang, just like that, the lead went back to 11, 12 points. And he's also got the ability to hit the three-pointer. All right, let's take some more calls for Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol. Hello.
Good evening. Jeff, how you doing?
Okay, how are you?
Miss you playing. Can you give me a day when you think you'd be back, and have you been selected, or will you play the All-Star game? Thank you.
Excuse me? I didn't hear that.
The All-Star game. Have you been selected, and will you play?
No, they haven't chose a team, and I doubt very much that I'll be selected. I haven't played that many games this year, so... Rightfully so, I think someone else probably deserves to be
Although
there.
Although you're getting a lot of votes, from what I understand.
I'm still about 150,000 behind, and if my mother doesn't, you know, pick up the pace. But I'm getting better, and the doctor said I could go ahead and practice Friday, so I'm looking forward to that.
Okay, thank you for your call. Our phone number here is 202-822-6830 if you'd like to talk with either Jeff Ruland or Manute Bol. Let's take another call. Hello, you're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes, I'd like to ask a question, Manute Bol.
All right.
I'd like to ask him how do you like playing the NBA. And my name is Wim Wilson from Fort Washington, Maryland. I'd like to congratulate him for the well done job he has already done.
All right, Manute, how do you feel about playing in the NBA?
Oh, I think I have fun because I'm the first person from Sudan playing NBA right now. So, you know, I think I like to, you know, to do well for myself too, you know, for a few years. And, you know, and I can enjoy myself like what I do now. I'm enjoying myself right now, this year. And maybe I'll, you know, I like to see myself, you know, do well for a few more years.
You're obviously attracting a lot of attention in the NBA. Wherever the Bullets go, there are big crowds. They sold out the other night in Milwaukee. When we walk through airports, people stop, put their bags down, and stare. I know that's got to be rather difficult, but you're handling it remarkably well and actually seem to be enjoying it to some degree.
Well, I think, you know, like, what's happened is I got a question last week too, where we was playing against Clippers. It was about maybe 5,000 people in the game. And I say, you know, I asked some guys in the team, I say, what's happened to us, man? The fans, I don't think fans like us, you know. Like, were you playing, like tonight where we were playing, the fans was in the game, you know, I think, you know, they'll make you work hard and you know that you want to show your fans, you know, how great the team is, you know. So that, I mean, I think what we're going somewhere. I feel like I'm playing home. So, I mean, I don't feel bad because I like, you know, play in front of people and I can see my family.
How do you feel about it when they chant, Manute, Manute? Even little kids are doing it now, by the way.
I think, you know, I feel great about that because, you know, I feel like good people like you. You should like people, too. So right now, you know, I'm getting along with people. And I think, you know, that the most thing, you know, you got to do it first. You got to have friends. And after that, you can think about yourself.
I think you've got a good perspective on things. Let's take another call. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Hi, my name's Patty Brocker, and I'm calling from Crofton, Maryland. And I'd like to ask Manute Bol if he's got a girlfriend.
Manute Bol, do you have a girlfriend?
Yeah, I might have one now, you know.
He's not... Don't tell him.
I might have one now, but I'm not going to do the way what American people do, have 10 girlfriends, 20, maybe 5 of them. But I might have one now.
But you're not going to tell us for sure?
No, not today. Maybe next time.
All right. And on that note, we will take a break, and we'll be back to take some more calls for Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol. Manute, Manute. Our guests tonight on Home Team Sports Beat are Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol of the Washington Bullets, and we've got plenty of phone calls backed up, so let's get back to our callers. First call, please. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes, this question is for Manute or Jeff. I'd like to know, which team do they think will stop them, if any, from getting into the playoffs this year?
What about it? Playoff competition. Who can stop the Bullets?
There's a lot of good teams out there. Of course, you have to go, with Boston right now, in our division anyway, you know. There's no doubt about it at this point in time that they're the cream of the crop.
I think the Bullets have done remarkably well, kind of treading water until some of the injured people return. Gene Shue's really had to make some moves, and he's done a good job with his team. Wouldn't you agree, Manute?
Yeah, I think, you know, a couple of good teams, like maybe, Boston, Philadelphia, and our division, but I mean, we can handle another team. I think we can do good against other teams.
Now, I really sense things are coming together with this team right now. Okay, thank you for your call, and let's take another phone call for Jeff and Manute. Hello, you're on Home Team SportsBeat.
Hello, good evening.
Can you speak up, please, or could we possibly have our speaker turned up here in the studio? We're really having a difficult time hearing.
Okay, I didn't say good evening. My question is for Manute Bol. Do you think you're an important factor on defense or offense at the time being?
Well, I think the answer is obvious. He leads the league in blocked shots, so he is a factor on defense, but I know you want to become more of a factor on offense.
Yeah, but I want to be an offensive, but, you know, like the way we're coaching right now, you think that I can help the team in defense, and, like, sometimes we shot a ball, he told me you got to come on back, don't go to the offensive rebound, because other team been running, you know, they got a lot of running team. And he want me coming back to the offense, to defense. And he told me my offense is going to come along, but I'm going to agree with him too, you know. I think I can help on defense right now. Maybe next year I have both of them, you know. I can help on defense and offense. So right now I don't have to worry about offense. And I can pick one thing, say that I can be a good offense and not defense. I want to play both of them.
Well, you've certainly made great progress in your rookie year, and doing a wonderful job for the Bullets so far. And as I said, they lead the league in blocked shots with Manute leading the way, and it's quite a show to see at the Cap Center these days. Let's take another call. Hello, you're on Home Team SportsBeat.
Yes, good evening. My name is Wakena Tabor of Upper Marlboro, and I would like to ask Manute, do you prefer living in Africa or America?
That's a good question. Do you prefer living in Africa or in America?
I think I like to leave both of them because I got fans at home and I miss my country, and I like to live here too because I got fans here. So, I mean, I like to leave both the two countries, Sudan over here. It doesn't matter to me.
Are people basically the same?
Yeah, I think, you know, in this country too, some people are nice, some are not nice. So the Sudan, some of them are nice and some of them are not nice. And I like, you know, I like to stay here, but I'm not going to stay here without go back to my country. You know, I like to go back home and see your country and friends, you know, my cousin and family. So, I mean, I think I can leave both of them. Maybe I can build one house here and one in Sudan.
You're already thinking like Jeff Ruland. Oh, a winter house and summer house. You got it knocked. All right, let's take another call for Jeff and Manute.
Hi, this is Joe Downing from Falls Church, Virginia, and I wanted to ask Manute, who do you think the best center in the NBA is that you've played against so far this year?
Well, he's already said that Kareem is the most difficult center for him to play, and since he's the all-time leading scorer in NBA history, I assume that's your answer as to who's the best.
Yeah, I think Kareem is the best center right now in the NBA, but I don't say that, you know, like a couple of centers are good, but I don't think, you know, anybody can play. Like Kareem is about 39 years old right now, and he, you know, I don't think anyone can stop him in the NBA. How can you be 39 years old and you know, can play like what he did right now? That's why I think Kareem is a very good center.
Who else is difficult for you to play against?
I think Hakeem and Ewing.
Hakeem Olajuwon?
Yeah,
and
Ewing
Patrick
and Morrison Malone. Those three guys, them top, you know, because Hakeem, he's quick, and he's about 7 feet, he's quick. He's playing like forward. And I think Ewing is the same thing too with Hakeem. And I think Morrison Malone is tough because the man is too big and, you know, and he's very tough too to play him. So I think those centers are tough, but I don't think anybody is tough like Kareem.
What about Jeff Ruland in practice? Is he tough?
Jeff Ruland is tough, but I'm not going to talk about him because he's my twin roommate. I don't play against him. I play against him in practice. Somebody might talk about him someday.
All right, let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. Hello, you're on Home Team SportsBeat.
Yes, Jeff Ruland. This is Carlos Terry.
Uh-oh, Carlos Terry, a voice from the past, former Bullet.
Excuse me?
I'd like to know how long your arms are.
I have a 39-inch in sleeve. Sleeve, excuse me, Mr. Terry.
Thank you very much. Are you nervous?
Carlos, do you think Manute could block your jump shot?
Who, Manute?
Yeah.
He's a little too thin. I don't even believe he could be in the paint with me. Yeah, he's good. He's one of the best shot blockers I've seen. I respect him a lot.
All right.
Thank you.
Did you get those tickets today, Carlos?
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. Okay.
Carlos, thanks for calling. For those who may not know Carlos Terry, who played for the Bullets for several years, always a big crowd favorite. Let's take another call for Jeff and Manute. Hello.
Hello, my name is John McDaniel from Sutton, Maryland, and I'd like to ask Jeff, what did you think about
getting Leon Wood from Philadelphia.
What about the acquisition of Leon Wood?
Well, like I said, Leon is going to be a great player. He is a great player. You know, I was disappointed to see Kenny go, but certain things happen, and Kenny's going to do well in Philadelphia. I think it's an ideal situation for him. Leon, you know, I always knew he was a great player. I couldn't understand why he was sitting the bench in Philly. You know, even though they have Cheeks and Tony, I always thought that he would at least be the third guard off the bench. And I think, you know, we got a great player.
I think we've all been wondering the same thing. How could such a talented player with a great basketball background, a record setter at Cal State Fullerton, a member of the Olympic team, how could he not get a chance to play? He was regarded as the top point guard in the nation his senior year, but I think maybe you're right. He played behind Mo Cheeks. He's a guy who really needs to have the ball. I don't think he's an off guard. I'm not sure he'd be effective in that role. And with Cheeks playing so many minutes, and then he had Richardson and Tony and Sedale Threed ahead of him, so he just couldn't get any playing time.
Still wasn't getting any minutes. I mean, there's still some minutes available of a man of that talent.
Yeah, I agree.
But glad he's here.
We're glad he's here, too. He's played super for the Bullets so far. Thank you for your call. Let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. And that number again is 202-822-6830. Go
Hi.
Ahead, please.
I'm calling from Upper Marlboro, Maryland. This question's for Jeff Ruland. I find the Bullets extremely exciting, and I was wondering why he feels that there's such a lack of attendance at home games for the Bullets, and what he feels of Gene Shue as a coach.
All right.
What do I feel about
question.
The lack of it?
She feels the Bullets are exciting. Why isn't the attendance up, although there were 17,000 there today?
Something that mystifies me. I can understand that it's a transient town. A lot of people are only here for a few years, and they usually roof it around their own, you know, where they're from. So when a Philadelphia or a L.A. comes into town, you see that the stands are packed, but half the crowd is rooting for the other team. Might be a problem with transportation. I really don't understand. I know that the year that they won the championship, they only drew about 11 or 12,000, so it's always been a problem.
You know, As I say, I sat in the stands today with my family and watched the game, and it was really enjoyable, but I sense something is changing. The other night when Manute was blocking shots and Leon Wood had a team running up and down the floor, I saw the fans get into that game more than I've ever seen here before in a long, long time, except maybe my first year, the year after they won the championship. So I think that might all change if this team continues to progress as they are.
Well, I think Manute made a great point when he says, you know, when the stands are filled, you play that much better. There's no doubt about it.
And the Bullets have come up with a new promotion on the tell screen at the Cap Center called Manute's Blockboard, and they're keeping track of his block shots per game and for the season. It's really a novel idea. I think fans are going to get a kick out of it. Now about the last part of her question. You don't want to get in trouble, I know, but you don't want to be traded to Philadelphia either. But what about Gene Shue as a head coach? How would you evaluate him?
Gene has helped me tremendously. He's the only coach I've had since I've been in the pros, and, you know, I attribute a lot of my success to him and Bernie. And, you know, I think he's got my respect. I'd just soon play my whole career for him.
That's great. All right, let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Okay, my name is Charles from Frederick, Maryland.
Okay, can you speak up?
Turn down your set.
Okay, my name is Charles from Frederick, Maryland. I would like to know if Manute Bol is ever going to develop an outside game.
I can't. Did you hear the question?
He wanted to know if Manute was going to develop an outside game.
Outside 2 feet, I think. Now, what about a Manute in terms of shooting range and your offensive game? How would you like to develop? How are you capable of developing?
I'm never Rob Thompson. I can't shoot outside, so I have to develop my inside game that I'm going to do. But I'm not going to say that I'm going to develop my outside game, because I don't think 7'7" can shoot outside. Play like a forward, old guard, and outside.
What would you like to develop? A little jump hook?
I like to turn around, jump shot, and hook shot. You know, one dribble, left, what I want to do.
I'll never forget that game. I believe it was against Utah when he had the ball at the top of the key and went around Mark Eaton, one dribble, one step, wham.
Yeah, sometimes I feel like doing it, but, you know, maybe every game right now I got foul trouble, and maybe they might call offensive foul on me, so I don't have, you know, to do turn the ball over. I feel like doing it, but I might do it maybe next year. They might, you know, I'm not going to be rookie anymore next year, so maybe I can play grass, you know, top. On offense and defense.
All right, Manute, let's take another phone call. We're on Home Team Sports Beat with Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol. Hello.
Yes, my name's Jim Murdoch, and I would like to know if Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol, if they both start together, if what positions they will play.
Well, Manute would be the center, and Jeff would be basically a power forward. But as I see it in the Bullets offense, those positions are kind of interchangeable, aren't they?
They are very interchangeable, and like I said before, prior to my injury, that's what we were doing. You know, I was playing power forward, and we had Manute back, and we were pressing a lot, and we were playing really well.
And we should not neglect some of the other fellows who've been playing so well in Jeff's absence, Dan Roundfield, Cliff Robinson, Charles Jones. They're all going to be involved in the rotation once you return. They're all going to be getting
plenty
of minutes.
Very deep team.
Okay. We will take a break, and we'll be back to take some more phone calls. If you'd like to talk with either Jeff or Manute, give us a call at 202-822-6830. We'll be right back. We thank you for joining us this evening. We're talking basketball on Home Team Sports Beat with Jeff Ruland and Manute Bol of the Washington Bullets. We'll get back to the phone calls in just a moment. But I did want to ask you a question. I know you're a member of the Dinka tribe, which, as I understand it, is the tallest tribe in Africa. Now, how tall are the other people in your family?
I think my mother was 6'10".
Your mother was 6'10"?
My sister is 6'8", my father 6'8". And I don't see my grandfather anyway, you know. My grandfather was telling me about him, you know. He was really tall.
How tall was he supposed to be?
7'10".
7'10"?
Yeah. And look at, you know, like the people right now, they think in these countries, all the people in Africa and Dinka tribe, them too tall. But, you know, look at some guys. My father got a cousin about four or five maybe. And that way, you know, like in this country too right now, they got 7'4", 7'5", and some of them are not that tall.
What's the tallest person in the Dinka tribe that you've ever seen?
No one. I heard about my grandfather.
He was the tallest?
Yeah.
7'10"?
Yeah.
Are there any short people in the tribe?
Yeah, I think that 4 feet, 4 or 5.
4 feet?
Yeah. Some of them are short, some of them are tall.
What do they say? Hey, Shorty?
what them say about some guys right here, short people? Right?
When these people stop you in the airport and look up to you, I see them do it all the time. What are they normally asking you? What questions do you hear over and over?
They ask me, how tall
are you?
Yeah, how tall are you? I'll grab sometimes.
What else? How's the weather up there?
It's not my question here because I'm not a weatherman. They should ask. I'm not a weatherman. They should ask. They should ask Tom. Ryan, who's that? Channel 4. They should ask
go with Tom
Bob.
Kurian or Gordon
yeah?
Barnes.
Yeah. Go with Bob.
They should ask those guys. You know, I tell them, yeah, you should ask Bob Ryan because it's not my question. I'm not a weatherman.
That's a good answer.
Yeah.
All right. Let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. You're on Home Team Sports Beat. Hello.
My name is Pano Hawk. I'd like to ask Manute Bol a question. I'd like to ask him what he needs to improve in his game to be a blue chip center in the NBA.
What do you need to improve in your game to be a top NBA center?
I like to put some weight, more weight on me. So, you know, like when I weigh 225, 220, I don't think they're going to push me around. So, you know, I can be a good offensive and defensive player.
Do the Bullets have you on a special diet to try to put weight on you now?
You know that there are no time right now. You know, we're traveling every day and got a game, back-to-back game. You know, I'm missing weight room right now. I've been not lifting about a month now. So, I mean, you know, before that I was, you know, on a diet, eat, you know, like to make sure I eat four times a day.
Three, four times a day?
Yeah, but right now I'm not doing that because we're on the road. You know, maybe you might, the same, you want to eat lunch at the same time, you might be in the flight. So.
Yeah, no question, it's difficult. Yeah.
So
What's your favorite American food?
It's a lot of food, you know. There are a lot of good food, but I don't have a pick of one favorite food right now because it's a lot of good food.
Like them all.
Hmm?
All right, let's take some more calls for Manute and Jeff. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes, my name is Philip Betway from Springfield, Virginia. I have a question for Mr. Ruland. With the trade of Ricky Mahorn to Detroit this year, how did that hurt you, not necessarily on the basketball court, but off the court, because I knew you were very good friends? And also, how did that also then hurt the team because of his personality?
Well, Ricky was probably my best friend, and it hurt in that sense. But I talked to him every few days during the week, and that's part of basketball. Everybody gets traded. I lost him, but I've gained another friend in Manute, and You know, I think Ricky's in a situation where they're not doing well right now, but they definitely have a good team, and the opportunity's there for him, you know, to have a good year and to do well. And I wish him the best.
I guess that's one of the sad aspects of this business. There aren't many, because it is a pretty good business to be in, but sometimes you develop friendships and there is so much change in professional sports that people do move on. You lose contact with them after a while.
There's no doubt about that. You know, Carlos, who called tonight, used to be on the team, and it was one of the saddest days, you know, I've had, besides, you know, with Ricky when,
but it doesn't last.
He got released. No, it doesn't.
Okay,
nothing does.
That's right. Let's take some more calls for Jeff in a minute. You're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Hello.
Hello there.
My name is Ed Woodbury. I'm calling from Upper Marlboro, Maryland.
All right.
I have a question for Manute Bol. I'd like to know, when the season is over, does he plan to go back to Sudan, or does the present political situation allow him that chance to go back?
What about after the season? Do you plan to go back to the Sudan, or will you allow? Are you allowed to come back?
No question about it. I'm going, you know, see my sister, because I've been not seeing her for long, you know, for 2 years now, since 1984. So, you know, I want to finish my job first. After the season over, I'm going home for a month, 1 month, maybe coming back, you know, work out again.
There's no problem politically going
no,
back?
No, I don't think any problem, no problem.
Okay. Let's take some more calls. You're on the air with Manute Bol and Jeff Ruland of the Bullets. Hello.
Hello, this is Alan from Falls Church.
All right, Alan.
It certainly seems like Darren Day has been playing very well recently. Seems like he might deserve some more minutes. What would you all think? And secondly, can't the Cap Center do something about improving the seating arrangements out there? We've gone out several times, and you can only get seats that are way out on the fringes, and all the season ticket holders don't appear, and you just can't move in there at halftime or something like that. Certainly would make it better for the rest of us if we could move in.
Well,
thank you.
I've heard that argument in various places around the league. If the people who purchase the season tickets are not there for the game, why can't we go sit in their seats? Well, that's just not fair, because they're shelling out a lot of money to buy season tickets. They're their seats to do with what they want. If you want to be assured of having good seats, I suggest you buy season tickets. That's the best way to be assured of a good seat.
Well, I don't think there's that many season ticket holders, so there should be some good seats available. You shouldn't have a problem.
I would think that for most games, today might have been an exception because there was a big crowd, but I would think for most games there would be plenty of good seats available. And they do have the different ticket plans. You don't actually have to buy a season ticket. There are other ticket plans that you can purchase to allow you to see more than one game and be assured of good seats. So, but I would contact the Bullets ticket office about that kind of thing. Let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. Hello there.
Yeah, this is Richard from Fairfax.
All right.
I wanted to ask Manute, did he play any other sports in the Sudan? And what about that lion story?
Well, we've already covered the lion story.
Okay.
So, and we're all getting kind of tired of hearing about it. So you might ask your friends who watched the show. He did kill the lion. The lion was asleep. A lion had killed some of his family's cows, and he thought that it might be the same lion, so he killed it with a spear. That's basically the story in a nutshell. What about other sports when you were growing up in the Sudan? I know you played soccer.
Yeah, that's what I tried. I tried to play soccer for 2 years, 1 year, and I broke my toe, so I quit. I tried to kick a ball. I missed the ball, and I kicked the ground.
You kicked the what?
I kicked the ground.
The ground?
So, yeah, so I just quit because I broke my toe. And I don't play another sport.
What do youngsters growing up in the Sudan play? What are the sports that they play?
Some of them like to play ping pong.
Really?
They like to play tennis. You know, some of them want to be boxing. Some of them want to be soccer player.
Is there one favorite sport?
Oh, yeah, soccer.
Soccer?
Yeah. Soccer and tennis, boxing. People love it down there. Same.
You know, I've noticed that for a man who's 7'7", you run the court remarkably well. Is that because of your soccer background?
No, what I, you know.
From the Lions.
Like.
Jeff says it's from chasing Lions.
No. I used to play, like, when I started playing basketball, I've been practicing twice a day, you know, 3 hours in the morning, 3 in the evening. And, I like to run a lot, and what I play, you know, I don't feel like tired. If I tired, I try to push myself a lot, and I've been playing home. I play 40 minutes. I came in this country. I play in college. I play 50 minutes, 40 minutes overtime.
Can you run the floor better than a lot of players in this country who've been playing their entire life.
No, when I was in college, two people say that this guy can't run. You know, he don't run in the floor. And right now, I don't know, it's a people thing right now, you know. I like to run. I don't want somebody to take an easy shot. And, you know, like, sometimes I feel like tired. And coach say, come on, run back. So, I mean, I try to push myself and come on back to the, you know, to the defense. So it's a thing you want to learn. You can learn it easy, you know. You push yourself. You can learn everything. So, I've been running a lot, practice in the morning and evening. That's why I learned basketball, and I learned to run from there.
Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat with Jeff and Manute.
Hi, I'm Anthony Holmes of Suitland, Maryland.
All right.
I would like to know, is Manute Bol planning to do any commercials with Jeff Ruland, and what kind of car does Manute Bol drive?
That's a good question. Because you're 7'7", can you drive an automobile? Apparently an auto dealer calling wanted to sell you one.
I don't know how to drive, but I like to, you know, I might learn how to drive in summer. And right now, you know, I got a deal with a guy named Bill. I got the LTD right now, but, you know, friends of mine driving it.
And you sit in the back seat, right?
Yeah, I can sit in the front, but, you know, I don't have to sit in the front because somebody told me, well, you sit in the front, if you have accident, you might get hurt. So that's why I sit in the back all the time.
Sit in the back and put your feet up?
Yeah, because I don't want to get hurt. Maybe we get accident. And maybe I might get a truck. I like to get a truck. I'm not going to get BMW, Mercedes. I might get a truck for myself, you know, and I can drive it.
What about endorsements? Are you doing any commercials now?
Yeah, I did a commercial with Nike.
Nike?
And I might do a couple of commercials, maybe.
You know, I've said this before.
If I'm good, you can do a commercial. I mean, nobody know you. Nobody know me now, maybe.
They
two
know
more
you.
Years. Then if people know me, maybe I might do a few more commercials.
I thought it was great. A great idea would be for you and William the Refrigerator Perry to do a commercial, maybe for a food chain or a restaurant chain or something like that, where he would explain to you how you could put on weight. What do you think of that?
Yeah, you can say that, but I don't like to put on weight like what you did too.
You don't want to be as big as the fridge?
No, that's too much, you know. You might get hurt when you walk.
What about as big as Jeff Ruland? Would you settle for that?
Oh, yeah. I can be bigger like him. No more than that.
All right. Let's take some more calls for Manute and Jeff. Thank you for waiting. You're on Home Team Sports Beat, and we're in the stretch run.
Okay, my name is Sean Geeston, and I'm from Clinton, Maryland. I would like to ask Manute Bol, what is his shoe size?
What's your shoe size?
15 and a half.
15 and a half?
Yeah.
Which is not that big for...
Yeah, I got somebody's foot anyway. It's not mine. I should have maybe size 20, maybe 20-something. I got somebody feed me because I'm too big for a small feet, you know.
All right, what about your sleeve? How long?
About 38, maybe.
38-inch sleeve? What about inside?
Maybe. I don't think it's 30. My leg
pants.
Is 38, I think. No? I don't know. I don't worry about those things anymore.
You let the tailors worry about that.
Huh? Yeah, I let them work on it.
Do you have to have all your clothes specially made?
Yeah, I have my clothes specially made. And Jabron showed me that place, so I went down
maybe,
there.
Maybe people would like to appreciate how tall you really are. I'm 6'1", okay? Now stand up with me. We'll give people an idea how tall you are. Come on.
Yeah, I'm going to break this chair.
No, you won't break the chair. Just stand up. It's all right. Okay. Little comparison. Yeah.
Okay. I like to be more.
I wonder what it feels like to be like Mickey Rooney. Now I know.
I like to grow up more, too, you know.
You want
to
get a little taller?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's great. Let's take some more calls. Ooh, do I feel small. Let's take some more calls for Jeff and Manute. Hello, you're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yes, I'd like to ask Jeff Ruland if he thinks he has already reached his peak in basketball playing, or does he think that he still has to reach it?
You made the All-Star team. You've been among the leaders in rebounding and scoring. Do you feel that you can become much better?
Definitely. Definitely. There's always room for improvement, and that's what I shoot for every time I step on the court. I want to be better than I was the night before. And I'm only 20, just turned 27, so hopefully I have a lot more years ahead of me, and I'll get better every year.
Are there any areas specifically you'd like to improve on?
Sure. Try to work on my weaknesses. You know, I'm becoming a better and better defensive player. Try to cut down on my turnovers. Just like to play the all-around game.
Okay. Let's take some more calls. We've got about 10 minutes left on Home Team Sports Beat. 202-822-6830 is the number to call. Hi there.
Hello.
Hi, go ahead, please.
Okay. I'd like to refer my question to Manute. This is Marty from Farnsworth. Manute.
Apparently the gang is possible.
I would like to know, why are you always out, you know, on the offense and you never go out on defense?
I'm not sure I understand the question.
No, I am.
I guess he's referring.
I am.
You know what he said? Okay.
Yeah. If you never watching the game, I don't have to do it. Both of them. I like to play defense, not offense this year. So maybe I might be, you know, I might get there next year, not this year.
I know in the Chicago game last week, when George Gervin, they put George Gervin, who's 6'7" and not a real good defensive player, on you, they did run some plays for you.
Yeah, they run some plays on me sometimes, you know. And I mean, like what Coach said, that he think that like the big players, they might push me around and I couldn't get a good shot. So I mean, he should ask Gene that question. It's not my question.
I think it's just a matter of time before he becomes an excellent offensive player. He's only been playing the game for 5 or 6 years. And he's made, you know, tremendous progress already this year. So it's just a matter of time.
I mean, really, when you consider that the basketball players in the NBA are the best basketball players in the world, and Manute has only been playing basketball for 5 or 6 years, the strides that he has made already are really remarkable. In his first year with limited experience, he's leading the league in block shots. And I agree with Jeff. I think he will definitely become an offensive factor with a lot of work in the offseason, a lot of coaching.
That's why I don't worry about offense right now, because, you know, I knew, you know, I only played 6 years. So, I mean, I don't worry about offense. Right now, I'm not mad at and say why Jim don't put me in offense. He put me in offense, but when I'm mad at you know, I want to learn more from him and learn more from players. Maybe next year I can be a good defensive player. But I don't worry about that now.
We don't want you to fall backwards.
No, I'm not.
I don't want Bob Ferry.
I like to sit like that.
Well, don't fall over, all right?
No, I'm not.
We don't want you to get hurt.
Thank you.
It's one thing if you get hurt playing against Kareem, but don't get hurt here. Let's take some more calls. Hello, you're on Home Team Sports Beat.
Yeah, hello. Hello, this is Wayne Randall, Camp Springs, Maryland. And I want to know, which five of the Bullets do you think has the best chemistry? And I want to know, if Manute Bol, where does he get his clothes at?
Where did what?
Where does he get his clothes at in the area?
All right, we'll start with that question first. And where do you get your clothes? Do you have a tailor?
Yeah, I got my clothes made special here in D.C.
In D.C.? Yeah. Do you want to give your tailor a plug? You help his business? Mention his name?
You charge him too much.
Nah, it doesn't matter, you know. Well, you look good.
Maybe there's some other
Jeff Ruland knows him too, you know. He told me about this guy, so he know him a lot.
You don't want to mention his name?
No, Jeff can mention his name. I like to, too, but I forgot his name again.
What's his name?
He got his clothes through Raleigh's, I believe.
Raleigh's?
Yeah.
So tall that you can't walk into a big and tall shop and buy them, right?
I'll go down there sometime, but I don't find, you know, clothes. I can find shorts, but I can't find pants can fit me.
There's a funny story. When we went on a road trip to Chicago with the Bullets, it was about 20 below in Chicago, and we all had on our heaviest overcoats and stocking caps and mufflers and gloves, and we're ready to go, and we met at the Capitol Center to leave on the bus for the airport, and Manute did not have an overcoat. So Bob Ferry, the Bullets general manager, and Bob is a big man, he's about 6'9", he loaned Manute his overcoat, and that coat came to right here, didn't it?
Yeah, I think Bob helped me in that day too. It was cold by 1 degree in Chicago. So, you know, he's really been in Chicago before, but I never been in Chicago. He told me, hey, you gotta take my coat, you're gonna die. So, but I took his coat and I went down there. I said, hey, man, Bob was right, you know. If I don't take his coat, I'm gonna die.
Do you have an overcoat now?
Yeah, I got an overcoat made now.
All right. Let's take another call for Manute and Jeff. Hello, go ahead, please.
Hi, I had a question for Manute.
All right.
I wanted to ask how long his spear is.
How long what?
His spear.
How long is his
spear, I believe.
How long is the spear? How long is the spear you killed the lion with?
Bigger than knife.
Never mind. Forget that call.
He's bigger than knife.
It's big enough. That's a good answer. Do we have time for one more call? Yes, let's take another call. How big is your spear?
Hello. Help. Hi, I'm Joe Camo from Rockville.
Okay.
Yes, first of all, Jeff, I agree with Manute. You should wear a high-top shoe. I think you should, because you've been hurting your ankle so much. I agree with Manute that you should wear a high-top shoe.
Okay, I'll
and
keep
second of all, I think Bob Ferry really did a great job this year recruiting, especially Leon Wood. He's really bringing a lot of spirit to the team, Leon, especially with his three-pointers, and I think it's a great acquisition, Bob.
Okay, Leon, thank you for your call. No, we're only kidding. Go ahead. I'm sorry. Well, let's take one more. Do we have time for one more? All right, one more call.
Yeah, I would like to know how many games over 500 do you think you'll finish now that Jeff Ruland will be back shortly, and whether Manute Bol is really older than people say he is.
What about it, Manute? How old are you?
23.
Bullets are listing your age as 23.
Now, what I say to him, I don't know why people don't believe. I believe somebody age.
You don't look a day over 20.
Huh?
You don't look a day over 20.
No, I'm 23.
You're 23?
Yeah, my birthday was October 16.
Do you have a birth certificate?
Yeah, I got that.
You do have one?
Yeah.
Will you bring it with you next time you come on the show?
Yeah. What? You want me to show?
Yeah.
Who
you didn't bring it with
it?
You tonight, did you?
Who want to see it? No.
No.
Why do I have to bring it?
No.
Who want to see it?
No. We're just, as we say in this country, pulling your leg. And the other question was, how many games above 500 can the Bullets finish?
Well, it's almost halfway through the season. I wouldn't be surprised if we were finished 15, 16 games above 500.
All right.
But that's a prediction.
And I won't ask you about your spear.
Thank you.
Jeff, Manute, thank you. We've enjoyed
it. You're welcome.
We wish you continued success. You're having a great year.
Thanks.
I wish you good health.
Thank you very much.
Glad to have you back. Good to have you back.